क्लास 11th सब्जेक्ट फिजिक्स 6th चैप्टर मैकेनिकल प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ सॉलिड्स मैकेनिकल प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ सॉलिड्स लेट अस सी फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ दिस चैप्टर द सॉलिड्स आर मेड अप ऑफ एटम्स और ग्रुप ऑफ एटम्स विच वी कॉल इट एज ए मॉलिक्यूल which are placed in a definite geometric arrangement. The solids are made up of the atoms or the group of atoms which are placed in a definite geometric arrangements. So due to this definite geometric arrangement of the atoms or the group of atoms, the solids will possess the definite shape and size. So the definite shape and size will be possessed by the solids on account of definite geometric arrangement of the atoms or the group of atoms. If an external force is applied to a solid, at that time the constituents, that is particles of that solid, are slightly displaced. There will be displacement of these particles and hence the restoring forces are developed in it. So when externally force is applied on any solid, at that time its constituents are slightly displaced and the restoring force are developed inside the solid. So the force will try, this restoring forces, the restoring forces will try to bring the constituents back to their original positions. So when the restoring forces are exerted by that solid, at that time these forces will try to bring that solid to its original position or the original shape and size, so that solid can regain its original shape and size. When the deforming forces are removed, when the deforming forces are removed, at that time the interatomic forces will tend to restore the original positions of the molecules of the solid, and hence it will regain its original shape and size. So as soon as the deforming forces are removed, at that time the interatomic forces of that solid will try to restore the original positions of the molecules, and that body will regain its original shape and size. So in this case, if you consider a small strip of rubber and if it is pulled in the outward direction from its two ends, that is at the two ends of that strip of the rubber, external forces are applied in the outward direction. At that time, due to these external applied forces, there will be change in the dimension, that is shape as well as size of that strip of the rubber. And therefore, these externally applied forces, which changes the shape or size of the given solid, are called as deforming forces. And therefore, with our hands, that force which is applied in the outward direction will act as the deforming force. At the same time, it will be observed that that strip of rubber will also exert the opposite force on our hand. That is, that force will be acting in the inward direction. And therefore, that force will try to bring that strip of the rubber to its original shape and size, and hence that force will be called as the restoring force. So externally applied force will be deforming force, and the force applied by that body which is in the opposite direction to that of deforming force is called as the restoring force. Now the change in shape or size, or both shape and size of the body due to the external force, that is deforming force, is called as the deformation. The change in shape or size or both shape and size of the body due to the external force is called as deformation, and the force which produces deformation in that body is called as deforming force. A large deforming force will produce large deformation in that body. That means as magnitude of the deforming force increases, the amount of deformation of that body will increase. The deformation in solids is in the form of change in length, change in volume, or change in shape of that solid. When the deforming forces are applied on the solid, at that time there may be change in its length or shape or volume of that solid. The nature of that solid is decided by the property called as elasticity or plasticity. What is actually the nature of the solid? So it will be decided by the property called as elasticity or plasticity. And therefore, now let us see the elastic behavior of solids. As the properties are elasticity and plasticity, let us see the elastic behavior of the solids. So if you consider the elastic behavior of that solid, then in this point we will have to study what is elasticity, what is plasticity, then what are the elastic materials and what are the plastic materials. And therefore, the property of a body by which the body regains its original shape and size after the removal of deforming force is called as elasticity. The property of a body by virtue of which that body will regain its original shape and size after removal of the deforming force is called as elasticity. If the body regains its original shape and size completely after the removal of deforming force, then it is called as perfectly elastic body. So if the body regains its original shape and size completely after the removal of deforming force, then it is called as the perfectly elastic body. So in case of elasticity, due to the deformation or deforming forces, there will be deformation of that body. But as soon as the deforming force is removed, that body will regain its original dimensions, that is shape and size. And therefore, such type of property is called as elasticity. So if you consider the examples of some of the materials, that is elastic materials, then these examples are metals. So metals, rubber, cords, etc. are having the property of elasticity, that is these materials are elastic in nature. Metals, rubber, cords, these are the examples of elastic materials. On the other hand, the property of the body by which it does not regain its original shape and size after the removal of deforming force is called as plasticity. The property of the body by which it does not regain its original shape and size after removal of deforming force is called as the plasticity. That is, in case of plasticity, that body will get deformed due to the deforming force. But even if the deforming force is removed, that body will never regain its original dimensions, that is shape and size, so that it is called as plastic body, and that property is called as plasticity. If the body does not regain its original shape and size and thus remains in its deformed form after removal of deforming force, then it will be called as plastic body. So if you consider the plastic body, then for plastic body, if the deforming force is applied, then that body will get deformed. But after that, even if that deforming force is removed, that body will never regain its original dimensions, and therefore it will be plastic materials. So these are clay, putty, plasticine, thick mud, etc. are the examples of the plastic materials. Clay, putty, plasticine, thick mud, etc. These are the examples of the plastic materials. And now let us see the next important terms, that is stress and strain. Stress and strain. Now what is stress and what is strain? Both these terms are related with the elastic behavior of the solids. So let us see first of all stress. It is defined as the internal restoring force per unit area of a body is called as the stress. The internal restoring force per unit area of a body is called as stress. That means internal restoring force per unit area. So internal restoring force divided by area will be called as the stress. But that will be used in case of definition. But while writing the formula for stress, we can write deforming force per unit area is the stress. So stress equal to deforming force per unit area. As per definition, it is internal restoring force per unit area. Internal restoring force per unit area. But for practical purposes, it is very, very difficult or impossible to measure the internal restoring forces exerted by these solids from inside. And therefore, we can say that internal restoring force and the deforming force will be equal in magnitude. Though they are in opposite directions, their magnitude is the same, that is deforming force is equal to internal restoring force, and we can easily measure that deforming force as it is applied externally. And therefore, stress is given as deforming force per unit area. Deforming force per unit area, and that will be equal to F upon A. F upon A, that is the deforming force. This is area of that solid, and therefore deforming force per unit area will give us this stress. Now, what will be its SI unit? So, SI unit of the stress will be SI unit of force divided by SI unit of area. SI unit of force is Newton, SI unit of area is meter square, and therefore SI unit of stress will be Newton per meter square, while CGS unit will be dyne per centimeter square, dyne per centimeter square. Or this Newton per meter square, also called as Pascal, that is denoted by Pa, since it is force per unit area, it will be nothing but similar to pressure if that force is perpendicular to that surface. So Newton per meter square or Pascal, that will be the unit for this stress. Now let us see the dimensions of the stress. So dimensions of stress will be equal to dimensions of force divided by dimensions of area. Dimensions of force are 1 in length, 1 in mass, minus 2 in time. It will be divided by dimensions of area, that is 2 in length. So simplifying it, we will get dimensions of stress equal to minus 1 in length, 1 in mass, minus 2 in time. Minus 1 in length, 1 in mass, minus 2 in time. These are the dimensions of stress. And now let us see second quantity, which is nothing but the strain. What is that strain? So when stress is applied, that is force is applied on any body, at that time there will be change in its dimensions. And therefore we can define strain as the ratio of change in dimensions of the body to its original dimensions. The ratio of change in dimensions per unit original dimension of that body is called as strain. And therefore we can write strain will be equal to change in dimensions per unit original dimensions. That is ratio of change in dimensions to its original dimensions. So change in dimensions upon original dimensions. It will be similar to that of change in length per unit original length or change in volume per unit original volume, like this. And so this ratio is called as strain. But here it is the ratio of two similar quantities, and therefore as these two quantities are similar, that is length or volume like this, and therefore this strain is unitless. And as it is unitless, it is dimensionless. It will be unitless and dimensionless. That is, strain is unitless and dimensionless as it is the ratio of two similar quantities. So this will be regarding stress and strain, where stress is internal restoring force per unit area or deforming force per unit area, and strain is change in dimensions per unit original dimensions.